I enjoy experimenting with industrial Ethernet switches, and especially mixing equipment from different manufacturers. It's a great way to get a more detailed understanding of network functionality. I always follow best practice by resetting the devices to factory default before I start configuring them. Possibly more than once, if things don't go according to plan. But I really don't like having to re-enter the IP addresses. I could use DHCP, but that is just something else which can go wrong. Each manufacturer has its own tools for device commissioning, but running multiple tools is too much trouble just to assign IP addresses. Then I had an idea. Most of my industrial Ethernet switches support IPv6, and all IPv6 devices have permanent link local addresses. So why not use the IPv6 link local addresses? I could avoid entering IP addresses and at the same time try out the IPv6 functionality on the switches. That left me with one challenge. How can I find out the IPv6 link local addresses without using any specialist tools and with the minimum effort? IPv6 supports an option to ping a specific multicast address, and the ping is sent to all connected devices, called nodes. Devices which support IPv6 will then respond to the originator. This is exactly what I want to achieve. Now I'll show you how I used the multicast ping so you can try it yourself on your own test networks. I'm doing this on a PC running Windows, but the principle is the same for other operating systems. To make the screenshots less cluttered, I've disabled all the PC network interfaces except the one I will be using for the demo. The remaining interface must have IPv6 enabled. No other IPv6 configuration is required. I need to know the interface number of my PC's Ethernet connection. One way to find it is to use the root print command. In this case, the interface number is 39. Take note that the interface number could change after a reboot. You can see that the network interface is an external USB Ethernet adapter. Another option is to use the ipconfig command. You can see the IPv6 link local address followed by a percent sign followed by the interface number. Use the network shell command to see which IPv6 addresses have been learned on the network interface 39. Network shell, interface, IPv6, show, neighbors. In this case, no IPv6 addresses have been learned. Next, I'll use the ping command to find the switches connected in my network. The multicast destination address is FF02:1, followed by the percent sign and the interface number. As you can see, at least one device responded, but I can't yet see how many devices responded. Now I'll use the same network shell command again. You can see a difference compared with the last time. On interface 39, 4 IPv6 addresses have been learnt. Their status is displayed as reachable. This is correct because I have 4 switches in my network. My next task is to find out which IPv6 addresses belong to which switches. I have several options to achieve this. All options require some effort, but I only need to do it once. The first option is obvious and the most laborious. Disconnect all the switches, ping one of the IPv6 addresses, then reconnect each switch in turn until one of them responds to the ping. I won't waste your time by demonstrating that. The second option will work well for me because my network consists of four switches from four different manufacturers. So all I need to do is look up the organizationally unique identifier, or OUI, of each MAC address. Let's do it. The IEEE has a web page which lists the OUIs. The URL is standards-oui.ieee.org. The first OUI on the list is 00-90-E8, so I'll search for 0090E8. This belongs to Moxa. So the IPv6 address ending in AE42 is my Moxa switch. Next, 2C86D2. This is my Cisco switch. 646038. This is my Hirschman switch. Finally, 945907. This belongs to Shanghai Hitech and Belden using the Hi-Scom brand. The four IPv6 addresses are now matched to the four switches. Of course, this would not have worked so well if I had multiple switches from the same manufacturer. So the last option is to open the graphical user interface of each switch. I can copy the IPv6 address from the command prompt. In the browser, the IPv6 address must be enclosed in square brackets. Here is the Moxa switch. Next, the Cisco switch. The Hirschman switch. And finally, the Hi-Scom switch. I could now bookmark the four URLs. But in the next video, I'll show you a more flexible way to access the graphical user interfaces and command line interfaces of each switch using Microsoft Excel. See you in the next video.